Well, good Saturday morning. Today is, I think, the 16th. But I've been working on this whole week. I posted a video on Monday, and this whole week I've been battling the rain almost every day. Rains, it quits, I go out, but I've been trying to paint panels like this one here. This one goes on the sliding door, but I haven't got it on yet. I did both them blue ones, actually this morning. The other ones I painted yesterday in a different color, and then it looked like it was gonna rain, so I quit, but I painted them this morning. I have to attach them. I'm gonna let that stuff sit up a little bit. Here's the other one. A little smudge on there, I can wipe it off. But just to get this stuff done, and let me show you what else I did. Now, here's this panel up here it's in, and I made these pieces to kind of cover this area up here and there, even these little pieces here. I mean, this, maybe they can bend this metal back a little bit and it'll fit better, but just to fill that in a little bit, it looks better. Jeff, if you're watching, all these pieces up here, the trim cabinet's going to come from about right here over both sides, but here and stuff, that's going to be your job. I mean, I could put all that trim and on the floor around, and you know, I've got a ton of stuff to do. I've been dying to get this thing to them, so I'm going to end up let Jeff do that, my son-in-law. And he can do it how he wants, or paint them, or whatever he wants. I have extra paint, I have everything, so that's what I'm gonna do. But now there ain't nothing left but the crying and starting these top cabinets. I measured out the aluminum I need. I'm gonna start on this side by the over the sink. It's gonna be 110 inches long. I'm gonna build the frames first and then go from there and decide where the doors I want. They're gonna be about 32 inches wide. I don't wanna make real small ones. You can't get nothing in or out of them then. So anyway, I gotta start them, and oh well, you know, what's the worst that can happen? But the metal for the bed back there from 8020, I don't know if they shipped it yet, do I can get the rest of that in. Also, there's one more addition here. You know, I had a hole up on top of the roof, not in the roof, but back there. So I added another solar panel. 300 watts is better than 200 watts, right? So I'm waiting on the triple Y connection to hook them up. I think I get it Monday. So once I get that, I can hook down all them cables up and tie them up, and you can see they all tilt, and get that finished up. It'll charge the batteries a lot faster. So I did that, and like I say, it's getting there now. If I can somehow whip out these cabinets, it would be good. So I'm gonna start on them, start cutting the metal for them, and we're gonna let it go from there. So everything else is pretty much, and when I get the metal for the bed frames, I get them in, and then I can make the back ones, and I can get the drawers, the stuff I need for the drawers, and put all them together. So I'm working on the countertops. Lauren, you might not like them, but we'll see when they come in. So anyway, I like them, and it'll be a focal point, how about that? So anyway, like I say, the weather has killed me. I've had, and the humidity, oh, I'm sweating to death. So I put this welding hat on just to try and suck up some sweat. But anyway, when I get going on this, I'll tune back in. I don't know how long this video will take to put together, maybe another week or so. So, okay, we'll talk to you later. Okay, there's not much change right now. I didn't really work on it yesterday, Sunday. Wasn't feeling real good. I don't know. Gail brought home a cold from work or something. I don't know. But anyway, today I made up this frame. This is the bottom frame for this cabinet right up here. Now the other piece will be an L shape coming up. I need to get other pieces. I have more just 1 inch, but to make it wide enough for the ends, for the doors, I need to go get 1x2, make them 2 inches wide. That way I have enough room for the doors to overlap. And there will be 3 doors on this one. They'll be about 36 inches long, and that'll cover this. This will be the bottom. I may put wood on the bottom of that to help, you know, or else I definitely underneath, but I may put it on the inside too. We'll see. But I need to go get some more metal, the wider stuff, the 2 inch, and that way I can weld that up in the top. And it might not take that long. I can get this one and bolt it up and go from there. So anyway, just touch in real quick and let me get some other stuff done. Just wanted to give a quick update. This Saturday morning. That's what I'm dealing with. So it don't look like I'm gonna get a lot done this week, or this time, and today anyway, until after this rain goes. But this whole week has been, Gail kind of brought home something, flu or something, I don't know, about had pneumonia most of the week, trying to weld up some of these cabinets and do all kinds of stuff. I don't want to cry, but I'm crying. Anyway, this is what I'm working on. This cabinet up here, all that metal work, that's what the top cabinet's going to be. There's gonna be one on this side too, pretty much the same. It's gonna go further, but there's gonna be three doors on this one. There'll be one identical on this side. And then as it goes up further where the wires are coming out, there'll be a radio there. It'll step down, there'll be remotes and stuff like that. So I need to start on that one now. This one is like the bottom cabinets. I'm going to just face it and bottoms. And I'm gonna put on the inside too to help support anything they put in it. So, but as you can see, it looks pretty decent, but it didn't always look that decent. Trying to do all this by myself, that piece about 11 foot long, and trying to hold it up by myself, hold a level on it, hold a tape measure on it, and well, it didn't work real good. I put it up, and then I realized, oh, the bottom's it was an inch too long. I don't know how I did that, but I did it. That's what happens when you do everything by yourself. Now don't look at my welds, they're not welds. I mean, one neighbor said it looked like ratchet. I don't know how often he looks at ratchet, but anyway, sorry about that. But I ended up having to cut it all back apart and re-weld it last night. So now that one's up. I'll cut this piece and use it for parts and pieces. It won't go to waste, but also is what I did this week. As you can see, I got the third panel up. It's all wired, it's producing, everything's good. Also, the other battery's in. I made the frame for it, I welded these up. I was gonna do that with that one, but I know as soon as I take these screws out and go to weld that up, they're not gonna line up and I'm gonna have holes in the floor. So I put a plate, welded it to this piece to keep the battery from sliding. Maybe I should cut this down. There's a weld right on the back side of this. Maybe I'll do that later, just ease that down some. But anyway, it's all hooked up. It ain't going nowhere. The batteries are going no place. Everything's working good. So I'm getting there. And these cabinets, you know, I always said there's a lot of things, this stuff's killing me, but this is the last, I want to say last big thing, but these things, if I can get these whipped out and facing them won't take too much time. The bed frame metal I ordered, I emailed them this week, you know, it's been a week and a half, what's going on? Supposedly they sent it out yesterday. I don't know, I didn't get no emails, but as soon as I get this bed metal frame done, I can measure out for the metal for the drawers down there and get the bed done. And then And that's the bulk of it, most of it. The cabinet tops, I emailed the guy about getting the stuff I want for that, waiting for a reply. So it's getting close, real close. You know, like I say, a lot of little trim stuff, that's, they can do that and do what they want, colors, whatever. So anyway, that's where we're at, and we'll see if I can get struck by lightning out here or whatever happens. So we'll catch you later, and if I get anything done today, I'll update you. All right, it's the end of the day. I had to quit around, oh, 3 or a little after. It's not much. Man, a monsoon come through here. It's, I don't know, about 6 now. So anyway, hey, like my shirt my daughter got me for my birthday. Of course, I told her, you know, after I give her this van, I ain't going to have a van. So I'm going to have to wheel it with the van when I drop it off. So anyway, here's what I was looking at. I got these cabinets up. The frameworks anyway, and that's what I'm doing. Here's the bottom ones of the other side. I'll go up front and show you, but they're pretty much the same on both sides. Now for the top piece, I'm missing one. When this one here, when I had to cut it off, I had to use the other piece I had for this one, which means I'm short one on that one. I really didn't think I was gonna get this far. And anyway, so now, I mean, now it's Saturday, but I could have easily finished this today, but now I'll have to wait till Monday just to go get that one piece. So here's what we're looking at. Like I say, it'd be faces on this and doors that'll go up on both sides. These will be identical in the same places on both sides. So it looks, it'll match from here to here is the radio. So it'll be a flat kind of a plate, right here. And then the radio, and then it dips down. My son-in-law was worried about if he put swivel seats and he tried to get up, he'd be smashing into the face plus over the head here. So it's what I did. I dipped that in, it comes off 6 inches. And what I need to do, here's the remote for the solar panels, and that's going to go right here. And then there's another longer remote for the inverter to turn it on and off and monitor system. So that's going to go right here, I think, till about right here. I think I got it marked about right here in here. And then from here to here, I mean, I'll have a little door, maybe I'll put a framework on it, but maybe just a little cargo net. I don't know. I'll put something up in there. But I didn't want to waste the space. I mean, I needed to do it here for the remotes anyway, so it shouldn't bother nobody's head. So it's good. But this is how it'll be. Like I say, I got all the pieces here going up cut. I just have to go Monday and get another piece of this 1x1 aluminum. And up top, my weld's gotten pretty good. Okay, I'll admit it. Here was a screw up. I measured wrong. So I actually cut a 10-inch piece and I welded it together. I'll smooth that off. Hey, it's not so bad. My welds, I played with the machine. I bumped up the power and it helped a lot. I may not have had enough power on it. So anyway, today I had the refrigerator on. I turned it on with the two batteries now to see how it would do. It took them down some, but of course it was from being hot. It wasn't, so it took a lot longer to chill it, but I just shut it off a little bit ago and it was cold inside. Plus with the clouds and stuff, so it drained the battery some. That's why right now you see it's about half. So we're getting some sun now. Not a lot, but we're getting some. It'll charge it back up. I just wanted to see. So definitely it would help to plug this into shore power, cool it off the night before, and then the 12 volt probably won't have no problem keeping it cold, so we should be good on that. But anyway, this is up now. The biggest thing is getting that other piece of aluminum, and then I'll start facing these. Man, this is a big project that I've been, again, dreading, but I know I needed to do, and this is probably one of the last big projects. I mean, I got a lot of other stuff, but a lot of smaller stuff, the drawers, the bed metal should be coming next week, hopefully. Anyway, they said it would. And then I'm going to make the platform wood. I was going to use, you know, like a lot of people would use either 5/8 or 3/4 plywood. That's heavy. Of course, all these frames, like this one here, weighs about 12 pounds. So there's not much weight to it. With all this aluminum, this stuff's going to be strong. It's going to be lightweight. Fuel economy would be good, and they don't have to worry about it. It's all bolted in. You see, I put screws here going through into the metal taps. I'll be putting on the same with here going up. These go into the ribs going over, and then I've got some going into the wood itself. So, I mean, the whole van shakes, so they're not going nowhere. So anyway, just wanted to update you on what I was doing, and I'm just playing in there now. So anyway, let me finish that up Monday and may hopefully get this thing back together. Talk to you later. I just wanted to touch in again. Still working on this, welding these top cabinets up. I got a few more welds to do on the driver's side, but this is it. All 13 feet of it, all at one shot, and I don't know, 15 pounds maybe, something like that, 20 at the most, 15 probably. Just like the passenger side, it's going to have the same exact doors to match. This here is where the radio is going. It steps in, remotes for the inverter and the solar controller, and this is a little storage area. So just trying to use as much space as we can, and like I say, I only got a few more welds, and let's see, 1, 2, 3 more welds to do, I think, and that's 3 or 4, but that's about it. And then I'll go ahead and put it up. Already in the van, I got some of them painted already, the face and a bottom piece for this side. And excuse me, here's some more. It's going to sit on top on the inside. So I'm going to wait and get these up and make the boards for that, paint them, and then paint them all at one time. So just a quick update. Yeah, this thing, like I say, 13 feet long. All one shot though. I'll bolt it up, and all aluminum though, so it should be great for whatever they need. Once it's bolted to the wall, to the ceiling, we ain't going nowhere with it, and we should be good. So anyway, when I get all this back up, maybe when I get the wood on it, then I'll touch back in and I'll finish up this part of it. For now, I still need to do the doors and everything. I still have to figure out what I'm gonna do with that, but anyway, I'll talk to you later then. Good Friday afternoon. It's been a long week. Working on these upper cabinets again, like I put in my other videos. Today's probably going to be, I'll put this video together today. I have the cabinets up and also the facing on it, the bottoms, all that stuff. I've really been talking to my daughter and son-in-law back and forth for the doors. Now, the cabinets are blue. I think it'd be too much to paint them blue, too. I don't know. I'm trying to do, suggestions maybe, but it's been a long week. Weather's played a real big part. Here, I'll put a pic in of what I've had to deal with, trying to prime this stuff, put a couple coats of kills on the wood to seal it, and then the paint, couple coats of paint, and let it dry. Here's a pic of what I had to deal with. Okay, now you can see that every day it's like this. You know, all of a sudden you're busy, you look up, and the sky's black. And just, it's as fast as you can put stuff away, then the storms for 2-3 hours. and then it quits and kind of dries up some. Humidity's like 300%, and so I try to get that when I can. Anyway, let me turn some lights on up here. This is what I come up with. I stepped this in because he didn't want it too far out over the seat, and plus he's going to put swivel seats on, and if he turns and goes to get up, they want a face full of cabinet. See, I have to make the doors yet. I got this bottom piece. I don't know how. I left it up in here. I got to paint this one. I've got it for this. As you can see, all the pieces in here, I got to wipe everything down. All the bottoms are in it, both sides. I have the plug all wired up for the 12 volt for the TV. I've got all the material for the doors, but I've got them cut even. I'm just not sure what I'm going to do with them. The heater, I've been doing a lot of small stuff. The heater, I drained all the water out. I turned it on a couple times. It's running great, the whole system. So I drained it all, put coolant in it. That's ready to go. Something else I did, which it isn't a lot of big deal things, but it just takes a couple hours. All this aluminum trim, cutting the angles and getting all that up. Trying to clean all the crap out of it, but so you can see I still need to vacuum it some. I got these pieces of metal today. They were supposed to be here a couple days ago for the brace on the bed. I have the plywood for the bed. I was going to go with a honeycomb, real lightweight, but God, would have cost me almost $500, and it just, to me, it just wasn't worth. We've saved enough weight in this thing. I mean, like them top cabinets, the framework of that big one was only about 15 pounds. So I'm going to use 3/4 birch plywood on this. I have it. I'll cut it tomorrow and put it in. Also, I have the metal. Like I said, I just put these up, centered them, and so I have material for legs. I'll work on that tomorrow. And once I get the legs in, then I'll put the plywood on top. But you can see there's a few little, after I painted all them parts and panels, I'm going to come back and touch a few little spots up, maybe roll another paint on, roll another coat of paint on, I don't know. But anyway, like I say, this video has been going on for a while, so what I think I'll do, I'll put it together tonight and put it out there, and then I got to play with these doors on here. I don't want just a plain blue door. I want something on it that's going to look really good. I haven't decided what it's going to be yet, though. So, anyway, I'll get to it, and I'll start a new video with that. It's almost done. There isn't much more to do. The drawers, a few things here and there, but everything seems to be working great. So, anyway, I'll turn this off now, and thank you for watching. If you got any comments, any suggestions for them doors, I don't know. So anyway, we'll catch you later. I'll start a new video tomorrow, and hopefully it might be almost the last one, because it ain't gonna be much more. I'm done with this thing, and it's heading west. So Lauren and Jeff, I hope you enjoy it. So anyway, we'll see you.